Okay, we're in Boulder and talking to Andy Wacker and Brittany Hutton, and they are going to run for Team USA tomorrow in the Boulder 10K. And Andy, you told me earlier this is like something that's been a long time in the making, and just tell us what's that been like and what does it mean to you to line up for USA tomorrow?
Yeah, sure, it means a ton. I've lived in Boulder for 9 years, went to see you, and it just seems like gosh, every year since I moved here, I've been wanting to do this race. I've been watching the race every year. I got to run in the Citizens race 2 years ago.
Yeah.
And yeah, I've been. It's so funny. Every year they, you know, they. Well, I go to the race directors and write them emails and say, please let me on the team. Yeah. I'd love to be on the team. And finally came through this year. So it's a huge honor, and it's awesome to represent the U.S. in your hometown.
No, they used to have the Colorado. Were you ever on the Colorado team?
No, I wasn't. So just a lot of years. Yeah, when you're in college, it's not really compatible with your schedule. And in the recent years, I've been banged up and just haven't been on the team. But
so this is your first year in a pro race.
It is. Yeah.
Right on, man. It's awesome. And Brittany, you won the Citizens race last year. And just tell us what was that like? I mean, running in the front of the women. you know, there's 50,000 people in the race, and you're ahead of
It was a great experience. It was crazy at the same time. I thought I was chasing a girl down. It turned out to be a guy with long hair.
Okay.
He upkicked me, so I don't have to deal with him.
Obviously. Yeah.
Great job, guy. But the whole time I was racing, I stayed confident, I stayed positive, and looked around at the people who were out there dancing and seeing people doing water slides, and I'm like, wow, that looks like so much fun, but I gotta crack this, like, I gotta do this. And coming into that stadium was a bit scary. It was the ground was like still damp from the morning, so I almost slipped.
Yeah.
But it was so awesome, and my mom and dad and my brother were there, and Brandon was there, my fiance, and his best friend, and just having all of that was so special. And now this year I get to experience it, but on the pro team, and even though my family's not here, I'm so grateful that I was able to get my foot in the door to for 2016.
Yeah, you both run this race, Andy. What's the keys to, you know, being successful in this particular 10K?
So I think it's like a lot of races. You have to go by feel, and you have to know what your body's capable of. So, they were just talking about it in one of the other interviews, but you have to be cautious. So it's easy to go out hard and get excited, but you know, it's a longer race, and so you got to know your body, know what splits you can hit, and just because the guy in the lead's running 4:20 per mile doesn't mean you have to do well. So I think you just have to listen to your body and keep calm through most of the race, and really turn it on after 8K.
Yeah. Did you train specifically for this race last year, Brittany, or is this just something you did for fun? Or
this was something that was going towards my training. I was trying to just get a faster 10K in to get into Portland last year. I wanted to get the standard in the 10K in August. And that didn't happen, unfortunately, but I definitely think that running this 10K is so vital for great training later on, because it is literally that race that can go out super hard, or it'll go out somewhat moderate, and then you have to pick it up, you know, and you have to make those right decisions. So you learn a lot coming out here and training hard, so yeah.
There's a ton of people out there on the course watching you run. That must be, like, really motivating.
It is, definitely, because, I mean, I typically do my workouts alone, so when I'm with people, I get, like, 110%, like, excited.
Yeah. How about you, Andy?
Yeah, same. I think the coolest thing is this race attracts 50,000 people to run it. Population of Boulder is only 100,000, so between, you know, the people participating and filling the stadium to watch our race and the Memorial Day ceremony, it's just incredible to see. You know, the number of people who are part of the community, who are part of the race. And so that's really special about this event.
And that, speaking about community, I just have to say, like, this is the first USA team I've ever been on. And being a Memorial Day, tear up. It is so, I feel that I'm representing more than myself. And I'm representing all the men and women who have done what they could for our country. And if I ever needed to go to the front of the line for our country, I would, because that's how much I know, I respect what they're doing, and I respect everything that these millions of people have given for us, for our freedom. Which, so when I step on that line, I just want everyone to know, this isn't about me. This is about those people who have fought, and I'm celebrating your lives and your memories and your commitment.
Yeah, that's awesome. Andy, you've done a lot of trails. But here you are back on the road again. Yay. It's awesome.
I know, yeah.
Is this what you got a new direction, or are you still into the trail thing, or?
Definitely into the trails. Yeah. So it's, you just got to balance it. I get bored doing any one type of race too long. So yeah. Kind of gave myself a road season from January 1st until now.
Okay.
And I was crossing my fingers all year, hoping to make this team and doing the right things. I've done some of the U.S. road circuit, the 15K, the half marathon, 25K. So all that's culminating here, and it's an honor to be on Team USA. So.
Yeah. Okay. So you're talking to PikesPeakSports.us, which is now the online magazine for the Pikes Peak Marathon and Ascent. And so I got to ask, Andy, are you coming back?
Oh, yeah. So Pikes Peak Ascent is top of the list.
Yeah,
so
okay.
Got a big trail season coming up this summer. And the stars align where I like to over-race and do too many races.
Yeah.
This year, a lot of races are conflicting, unconflicting weekends. And that's a great thing for me running the Ascent.
Yeah.
Because now I'm going to be stuck in Colorado to train and to really focus on that race. So it's amazing. I'm going to throw everything I have at it for about 2 months.
Right on.
And get up to altitude, and can't wait. So.
And so I've been mentioning to Brittany now for like a year of Pikes Peak.
Uh-oh.
Do you think this is something that could ever be in your future, Brittany?
Absolutely. I don't know when it's going to happen. I want it to happen.
Yeah.
I want to race up that mountain.
That's awesome, man.
Guarantee it.
All right, guys. Well, we'll see you at the starting line tomorrow. Boulder.
Sounds good.
Thanks.
Awesome. Team USA. Thanks a lot.